Hey guys, it's Hippokittie. It's been a while. Been busy working on different stuff and day job stuff and stuff like that, so I'm sorry I've been absent for a while. You're gonna be seeing more of me though. So today we're gonna be reviewing a movie that one of my friends made. He also made a game for it, so that'll be the next review. And it's Carpet Shark.
For 30,000 years, I was a shark. A shark of the ocean seawater. That was my home. That's where I lived. That's where I swam. But one day, a man took me from my home and took my soul and put me in a carpet. In a goddamn carpet. Tonight is the night that I feed. Not on the crap that he feeds me daily, but my master brings me people with real footsies and fingers and faces. I feed because I am the Carpet Shark.
As the intro to the movie describes to you, it's a story about a shark that was put into a carpet and feeds on whatever its creator or captor, whatever you want to call it, feeds it. Pretty wacky, if you ask me. Let's get this right out of the way. I love this movie. Like, I utterly love this movie. It is hilarious. I would love to have been involved in production of it. And from what my friend Steve stated, it was a lot of fun, and they've been working on trying to figure out a sequel for it for a while, and I'm waiting for that sequel. So, that's pretty crazy to me. Now, let's go into the scenes a little bit. This first scene is crazy to me, where you have the guy forgot his beer on the other side of the living room and throws down pillows to, like, get to the beer. Let's get into it.
All right, so first off, the costume is not bad. The wig's pretty good. You can tell it's a wig, but it's whatever. He walks into the carpet. It's like, oh, no, my beer's in the side of the room. How am I supposed to get to it? It's Keystone Ice. Like I said, he throws a couple pillows out there and starts to crack across it. And during the bloopers, he actually said that it was hard for him to do that. And I think it's like Vaseline that he's pulling out, or KY jelly. Yeah, it's kind of, man, crazy.
Make the shark some dinner. Dinner goes in the water. Carpet shark happy for dinner.
The elephant in the room is that the shark is extremely fake looking, and I think that was intentional. It's pretty funny to me. And to be honest, the creator guy giving it frozen dinners is pretty funny too. It's like, here you go, friend. Here you go, friend. I'm not going to lie, though. The first time I watched it, I laughed so hard. I almost pissed myself. The acting is both good and bad at the same time.
Alright, so here we actually have one of our potential victims who believes he's meeting up with, we're assuming, a minor that he's talked to online, that I'm assuming the creator actually went through and faked a account to lure this person that no one would miss in. As you saw from the sign, there was a full rent thing, so he's using things to lure people. In which case, we get our second victim here, which I love him to death. Check out this accent.
Room for rent?
Oh.
Y'all got a room for rent?
He then talks about how beautiful the house is, slash apartment. They keep calling it a house, but it's really an apartment. And then he goes on talking about how he lives in a basement, and he needs to get away from his crazy baby mama, which later on they imply is actually his cousin, which is kind of weird. But then he points this out.
One question. Why is there a diddler here?
You have two questions. It's like 300 feet from a school or a park.
Yes. And yes. Mm.
I have a feeling you guys aren't going to be renting the room for long. Now, as stupid as that joke was, it was actually pretty well done because of everything that's going on. But because of everything going on, he pretends like he's going to show them the house, but instead directs them straight to the carpet, telling them to put their feet in. Of course, they're a little bit hesitant of it at first, but they start doing it, and after they do that is when they're interrupted by my friend's character. And you gotta check this guy out.
I saw the sign and it opened my mouth.
And then after my friend's character is introduced, they direct him straight to, legitimately, the bathroom where this happens.
Yeah, they touched on some weird characters with the weird pedo guy with the Mickey Mouse shirt. Not gonna lie, that's weird to me. And my buddy Steve with his Municipal Waste shirt just looks like awesome. I love it.
After the bathroom scene there, he tries to talk them into going and putting their feet in the carpet once more. Steve's character and the redneck kind of guy were going to do it together. Redneck guy gets a little bit of a leg cramp, and legitimately, Steve just jumps into the chair, which they talked about in the bloopers, how they didn't really want to do that because they were afraid it was going to break, and they kept calling it a weird name, but it's a chair. It's whatever. After that stuff goes on, it goes to a scene where I can't show you too much, where the weird pedo guy went on Omegala and started trying to talk to people, which I don't think is 100% legal, because they were being filmed without permission, but during the bloopers, they were actually talking to some of these people. So, that happens. Then, the pedo runs into the room screaming, there's no kid, and then this happens.
Whoa! Buddy, wake up. Buddy. Buddy in the Pompey. Buddy in the Pompey, wake up. Wake up now. Buddy in the Pompey, wake up now. Buddy in the Pompey, wake up.
What?
A goddamn shark.
There's no Jimmy.
Come to Papa.
Preceded by the funniest scene in the entire movie.
There's a fucking shark in that carpet.
I got this.
Whatever you're fucking doing, stop. No, just... No, whatever you say...
Let this happen.
Don't. I can't let this happen. I really would not... No! No! Get off of the carpet! What are you doing? Honey, stop. You're doing it... Sincerely, all you have to do is get off the carpet. It's an 8x10. Move away. 11 feet. You're fine.
No, you're doing it all wrong.
Don't stop trying to roll. Move. You're not swimming. Buddy, stop. Why are you somersaulting?
You might be all right. You might be fine.
I'm not gonna even lie, the scene where he's like just going crazy on the carpet and like the guys in the background like, no, you can't, you just get off the carpet. It's a I can't remember the measurement right now, but he's just like swimming and breakdancing and stuff. There's even more of it in the bloopers, which is hilarious, because by the way, the movie comes with bloopers and they're just hilarious. I'm not sure you really call this a movie, though, because it's like not even 20 minutes long. I call it a short film, personally.
No. Where's the other guy?
Y'all know where he is. Motherfucking sharks ate him. You got a shark in your carpet? You got a shark in your carpet? How's that even possible?
He's been fed twice?
Yeah, apparently he's eating two people. And I'm kind of starting to think like I'm going to be a third person eating. I ain't trying to be eating. You know why? Because I
don't
want to go back home with my cousin and my kids.
After my buddy gets eaten by the shark, the creator comes in and is antagonizing, quoting weird semi-Jaws lines, which I'm not going to lie, are fairly stupid, but fitting for the film. Until this happens.
I owe him a favor, and that's you, Meaty, Muscly, and Medium Rare.
Come in here and take a swim.
Don't you dare touch me, you mother! Oh, you son of a gun! Oh, you son of a gun! Bitch, get out of the way!
That's my shark. Punch my shark in the head.
Yeah, I got that fucker.
Shark is about to eat my head.
Yep.
Then... the carpet shark eats the creator, of course. So the new guy has to take over and hang the for rent sign up to continue the legend.
I can't wait to eat you next.
Carpet shark! He's gonna get you on dry land.
Carpet shark!
That fucking shark don't need no sand.
Carpet shark!
He can kick its ass, he thinks.
Carpet shark!
And so, the legend of the carpet shark lives on. With a room for rent. Overall, on my personal scale, I would give this a golden potato. Like, everyone needs to see this movie. I would recommend watching that and anything else that Fista Studios has done. Honestly, they have several films, and they have a game for Carpet Shark, which is going to be my next review. It might not be out in time for Shark Week. Sorry about that. I've been a bit delayed with sending out like Ooze Redux and stuff like that. And my own band, Rejected Monsters, been doing stuff. But expect more soon. But To be fully honest, I'm not so worried about a carpet shark because I live in a house that has no carpet. It's all tile everywhere. So I don't have to worry about a carpet shark coming after me now, do I? What? Ah!
Tile shark! Tile shark! It's gonna kill you in your room! Tile shark! It's no longer stuck in the fucking carpet. Tile shark. There's nowhere left to go and save. It's gonna follow you into the bathroom. It's gonna follow you into the kitchen. Tile shark. It's gonna kill you where you go now. Tile shark. It's going into your office. Tile shark. Feed it to get free rent now. Tile shark. You're gonna be its meal one day. It's gonna get you no matter what. It's gonna get you in your butt. It's gonna kill you in. It's gonna fucking hurt. It's gonna kill you no matter what.